Yeah, so I think if Flash did come back, we would face a lot of what we just saw. There would be a lot of decks main decking Rest in Peace, just to have a good main deck Protean Hulk matchup. Because Rest in Peace is a fine card against like Tarmogoyf and Deathrite Shaman anyway. So it would see an uptick in main deck Rest in Peace, and then Red Elemental Blasts as well, like the red versions of Delver. Would see play over the other versions because they could play like three or four Rebs in their board. But I think I'm going to gamble on this hand. I just need to draw one mana source the first turn or two. We could have a turn one win with this hand, which is kind of nice. There's a Force of Will backup. See Storm do that. It is a risky hand though, because we could just not hit a land and lose the game straight up. But with, I think, 15 land in the deck. And we can miss for a turn or two and still win with this hand. If we draw like that. Okay, so he has a daze to interact with us, and that's it for this turn. And he doesn't have the mana to him us on his next turn. Probe Shot. Another one. Find us a land. Oh, that's not a land. That was highly unfortunate. All right. The good news is our hand survives him to Turok pretty well. The bad news is the daze is a hard counter, and he's got cantrips to find another one, another bit of hard disruption. I kind of want to force that. Because we discarded the summoners, so he could take the Protean Hulk out of our hand. Yeah, I'm going to force Pitch Brainstorm. He's going to daze. And then I think I pay with Simeon Spirit Guide. He's mostly brainstorming for information over there. Kinda wish I'd discarded the Body Snatcher in retrospect. Because then I wouldn't have had to counter the Thoughtseize. Oh, he has a second daze. Yeah, we probably just lose now because he takes the Protean Hulk. And leaves us with Flash Body Snatcher, and he gets us to him us in a couple of turns. I still think my keep was fine. I don't think there's many 6 or 5 card hands that would have been able to beat this draw anyway. I don't know. The chance for the turn one made me greedy. Greedy for sure. Yeah, and he takes the Protean Hulk. As he should. I'm just gonna have a couple turns of a little old back and forth. Yeah, if you're not winning the game on the spot, Pact of Negation's pretty bad. He hymns, takes nothing of importance. And we're back to being actually pretty close to comboing out. Oh, that's gonna be tough. So we can actually cast this Flash. So that's something. Oh no, not anymore. Maybe we should have held the Volcanic Island. Oh yeah, we definitely should have held the Volcanic Island. That was just stupid on my part. I don't think we can win anymore. Yeah, if we'd held the Valk, we could combo off here. That was just a misplay on my part. Pretty loose. Oh well. But you guys see how the win would have happened. Yeah, so a punt on my part. I just asked him. His last card in hand is Force of Will, so we would have won on the spot if I hadn't run out the Volcanic Island. Kind of just an autopilot play. I do that a lot more when I'm trying to commentate at the same time. But if you consider how much disruption I went through out of him, and I was still in a position to maybe combo off, it's kind of broken. Some misdirections coming in against his discard. Probably cut some number of Force of Will. Shave this Impulse like usual. And I think when he has Deathrite Shaman in his deck, we bring in Grave Titan as an alternative win. And I think we can safely cut a Carrion Feeder if we're doing that. And then maybe Pyroblast or Spell Pierce. Kind of like cutting Chain of Vapor for Pyroblast. Yeah. Main deck, it's nice to have Chain of Vapor as a way to Merchant Scroll for something that can answer a Deathrite Shaman to help me combo off. Postboard. I like since we have Grave Titan, I like an extra Pyroblast better. And I think the rest of this is fine. Yeah. Almost like Spell Pierce over Pact Negation, almost.